Hey everybody, Anna from eMedia Life. So this is gonna be a refresh video. So this is a refresh on my Skype tutorial that I did about a year ago. So it's 2021 now, the beginning of it. So perfect time to do a refresh video on that tutorial guide that I did. And for those of you who don't know what Skype is or just getting into it, it is a video conferencing platform. So I'm gonna give you a quick beginner's tutorial guide, so stick around to the end of the video. And as well, if you do enjoy it, always smash that thumbs up button and click that red subscribe button with that bell icon, because that's what keeps you posted when I launch all my future videos. All right, now let's get to it. Okay, everybody, so over here at the computer screen, let's get started. So first you'll go in your browser to skype.com, you'll go to downloads, and this from here is where you'll download Skype for your mobile or for your desktop, and it's available in Windows, macOS, and Linux. So before we do that, let's just head on over to the features, and this is what you get most out of your Skype. So you get audio and HD video calling, smart messaging, screen sharing, call recording and live subtitles, call phones, and private conversations. So these are just the features that Skype offers, just so we know before you get started. Okay, let's head on back. So we are gonna get Skype for Windows because I am on a Windows, not on a Mac. So I'm gonna click on it. So of course you want to allow your computer any changes that Skype wants prior to installing. Just give it permission and enable everything. Okay, and we are here. Welcome to Skype, free HD video and voice calls anywhere in the world. All right, let's go. Okay, so you have to create or sign in right in here. So if you click on that, create one, and you are going to go next. You're gonna create a password. What's your name? You'll put in all your demographics right over here. And it is gonna send you a code to the email that you provided, just so you verify it. So go to your email. Once you have your code, you're gonna click next. Okay, you have to solve this puzzle so they know you're not a robot. Okay, so here we are. Welcome, Anna Sidorsky. There we are. And let's get to it. Okay, so over here on the left over here would be all your recent chats that you'd have. Over here, you can actually search for people, groups, and messages if you were to put it in over here. New chat, if you clicked on new chat, you can have a new group chat, moderated group, new chat, or a new private message. So let's just say new chat. We click on new chat, and over here is where you search for people that you're looking for. All right, so then you click on the person, and then there you are. So over here, you have like a chat box, just like your kind of text messaging, you know, hello, and then you click send. And then also over here on the right, you can start the video call, or you can just simply have an audio call with them. And this human with a plus sign is to create a new group if you were to press it. Okay, so that's the chat. If we go to meet now, if we drop it down, you can host a meeting or you can join a meeting. So I'll go through both of them. So click join a meeting. And then this is where you would need that meeting link and code to join the meeting. So once you'd have it, you'd auto-populate it in here and then click join. And if we wanted to host a meeting, if we click host a meeting, over here you can choose your background effect, whichever one you want. Over here is your microphone. You could turn it off and on. This is the same thing to do your video off and on. Okay, so on the left. So what is this meeting about? So over here you can write what you want. So meeting with Anna sounds good. Over here is that link that I told you when you, if you'd want to join, somebody would have to give you that link. Well, this is the link here. So you can copy this link and then share it to whomever you want invited to the meeting. So you can go through your Skype contacts, do it that way, share the link this way, or you can share an invite. If you click on share an invite, you could copy the link and then auto-populate it, you know, whatever platform you use, or you can do it by your default email, Outlook mail, Gmail, and Facebook. Once again, here is that chat box that I was telling you about. And if you are all set, all you have to do is press start meeting, and there you are. So over here, because it's just me on the call, it would say how many are in the call. Over here, the grid view, you can change your views to grid view or speaker view or entire or the whole entire full screen. Over up here, you can add people to the call. Once again, you search, you put them in there, or you can share the link to others. Down here at the bottom is just in the call all in all, but this is your video, this is your microphone. To the left is share. If we click on share, once again, you can share with all these that are listed here, Skype contacts, copy link, default email, Gmail, Facebook. If you press record, it would record your meeting. Okay, over here is your chat box. Same thing as I was saying before. You could type your text message here. The three dots are just a little extra things. Like you could create a poll here, schedule a call, or if it's just a simple message, hello everyone. Press enter and then it would put it in here. Chat share screen is share screen. If you click on share screen, over here you can choose screen to share, and then you'd pick which one, and then you can share your computer sound as well. You'd have to enable it and you would click start sharing. So over here, this hand, it's to raise your hand. So if you pressed it, see, it says you raised your hand if you were in a meeting, and over here is some emojis and some stickers. And the more button right over here is just, you could choose a different background effect. And if you clicked on audio and video settings, you can go through your settings and adjust them accordingly over here. Okay, if we go to the top, there is that title that I put for my meeting, Meeting with Anna. If I clicked on the three lines, over here is just kind of what you saw in the previous window that I showed you. You have your chats, your calls, your contacts over here, and your notifications. So your notifications would be here. If there is any like reactions, quotes, or anything, would be in here. Your contacts, if you'd had any, would be all over here, or you can also add a new contact through this way. Your calls, any recent calls that you've had would go here, and same as for your chats, any recent chats would go here. So see, here is the previous one that I did earlier on when I said hello. And that is that over here. Over here, the three dots is just more settings that you can go through. So go ahead, check this out. You go into depth and adjust it accordingly to your own settings. Over here where it's your name and it has the dollar sign, see, mine's, I'm in Canada, so it's Canadian. If I click on that, here is where like you can call landlines and cell phones, but the only thing is that this does require you to have funds in your account. So this is a charge. So if we press continue, see over here, you have to get Skype credit. So let's say $5, you'd buy $5 and follow it that way. Or it tells you over here subscriptions. So, you know, United States, India, North America, it tells you, look, try for free for a month. You could click on that and try it out. Canada, right over here, Russia, and so forth. Minute and so forth. Then you can click on it, and then it'd add credit to your Skype account. And then that's where you could utilize this feature to call. And over here is just more options in regards to your profile, more settings, bookmarks, just shows you're active. Your profile picture would be here. You can sign out over here. And that is it, folks. There you have it, everybody. That is the end to that tutorial. Like I mentioned, to get more comfortable with it, go play around with the platform, look around, set up your settings, customize it as well, just so you're more comfortable and you lower your anxiety levels as well. Don't go into it right away brand new into a meeting or into a classroom or anything like that. It'll make you feel more comfortable and it'll save you a lot of stress. So with that said, that is the end to that tutorial. If you haven't done already, click the red subscribe button with that bell icon so you're posted when I launch all my future videos, and smash the thumbs up button if you did enjoy this video. I'll see you at the next one. Take care.